everyone, I'm Carol.
I'm Rob. This is Tilly. She's our little red dog. She was sleeping when we started to make this, but she decided she wants to become a YouTube star. So there we are.
We thought we'd get busy and make a video because we've been promising friends and family for a long time that we were going to document our boat life.
Yes, yeah, so you're joining us today on a very wet and windy day, I might add, on Narrowboat Liberty. She's our 55 foot by 6 foot 10 2004 narrowboat, and she's currently moored on the beautiful Lancaster Canal, not too far from Garstang.
In future videos, we plan on giving you a tour of Liberty, showing you what we've done to her and how we came about buying her in March of 2021.
Yeah. We've been fixing Liberty up since then, so we'll share her journey with you as well.
Our plan is to travel the network, all of the canals over the next 5 years, and really see the country from a different perspective.
Yeah, let's see how plans work out. We've planned lots of things in our life and then ended up doing something completely different. But we have made a commitment to Liberty and to our life on her, and so far we're enjoying it, and I don't see any reason for that to change when we start our adventure full time.
One of the things that we get asked a lot about is what made you decide to buy a narrowboat. So I'm gonna let you start with the things that appealed to you about it.
Yeah, I mean, we really started thinking about narrowboats during lockdown. Well, we had the opportunity at that stage to work from home, and we started to look at possibilities of not being tied to place. I was drawn in initially by the narrowboat vlogs. Some of the vlogs that inspired me initially were Kevin from Country House Gent. Really enjoyed his vlog. That's probably the one that most got me interested, first of all. And from there, probably through a pop-up, I discovered David on Cruising the Cut, which we both really like. Huge numbers of people really fell in love with his video style and the quality of what he produces. We really like the journey that we've seen from Cruising Alba. It's been an excellent vlog, and particularly their honesty in some of the struggles. Painting their roof was something that sticks in my mind in particular. So chugging along, we've enjoyed. We always have
a
giggle.
She's always so smiley and laughing, and I love their the
banter.
Yeah.
And Saul and Debbie,
who we
now know personally from Barely Floating. People that make us laugh.
Gives us a good laugh.
That brings an appeal for boating as well, and also another couple that we've recently met.
Yeah, surprised.
Is Keith and Bernadette from the Tiller people.
Yeah,
and we've got a lot of wisdom from their many years of boating.
Yeah,
and we've really enjoyed the insights that they've given us, which we would hope to be as calm and knowledgeable as Keith and Bernadette, but also to have the sense of fun that we see from people like Saul and also from chugging along. So I think really it's been quite a mixture of things, and obviously you see lots of other vlogs as well.
Yeah.
We really enjoyed Sort of Interesting.
Oh yes,
really enjoy.
Yeah, he's got
enjoy
some
his videos,
good videos,
Dan. And they're responsible for acting as a magnet to lots of people who've ended up buying a boat. And I met a couple yesterday, just as we were going out for a walk, and they're looking to buy a boat for exactly the same reasons. They've seen things on YouTube, and the life really appeals to them. You know, we had the possibility of buying a small home where we were land-based, it didn't really appeal that much. You know, it was the idea of living in a little place tied to a specific part of the country. And we wanted really a new life experience, didn't we? You know, we've lived in big places and small places. We've lived in America, we lived in Ireland, on the side of a mountain in a converted chicken shed, which was probably one of the best experiences of our life. So we're not afraid to live in small places.
We like adventure.
Yeah, and we just don't feel ready to stop trying new things and meeting new friends. I think it was also the aesthetics of it. I just liked the way narrow boats looked, and also what you could do with them, how you could transform them into homes that reflected your personality.
And as Rob was saying, we really wanted our own place. We had, ever since we'd come back from the States, and that was in 2013, we've been renting. And so the idea of having our own place was quite appealing. You know, when you rent, you have certain limitations. Although we've had fantastic landlords, and they've pretty much let us do quite a bit of what we wanted to do. I wanted my own place to kind of decorate and make it into our home. We like the idea of living somewhere pretty. We also have always loved traveling. Ever since we've been together, we used to travel a whole lot when we were first married. And so we like seeing new places. And I think that being on the narrow boat and seeing England from a canal point of view is going to be quite interesting. Even the city centers will be quite interesting. We love being around nature. You know, it's great when you get woke up first thing in the morning by a bunch of quacking ducks demanding their breakfast, and we've kind of spoiled them and created little monsters. But we love that. And we also thought, you know what, the cost of living on a narrow boat, once you get it fixed up, once you get it all ready, is quite small compared to living in a house. And it would really give us a good chance to stack away some money towards our retirement. And overall, it's just after everything that's happened, and a lot of you know about what's happened over the last several years, we really needed an adventure, something to look forward to. And so those were all factors for me.
It kind of felt like a new chapter in our life.
Yeah.
And our chapters have tended to be big, you know, big events.
We don't do anything small.
We don't do anything small. No, that's right. And you know, we'll bring you up to speed on some of the history of how we got here as well, and how we met. Obviously, we're not, you know, Carol's from the States.
Yeah, Indiana.
And you know, that's a story in itself, which we've been told that we ought to write about and share with the world. But you know, we'll do that in a future vlog, I guess. And you know, hopefully, if there's any viewers that don't know us, then through sort of asking questions or making comments, we'll become friends with a wider community, which is also another aspect of, you know, why we like boats so much, because the people we've met are fantastic, aren't they?
Yeah, they are. So far. I mean, it's a very friendly community. People are very laid back and down to earth. We shall see as we go, but as far as I know, the canal community seems to be wonderful everywhere you go. So anyway, we'll keep it short today. This was just our introductory video. If you liked it, hit the like, that we would really appreciate that. And if you want to keep up to date on our adventures, please subscribe, hit the bell for notification. And if you have any questions, please leave them in the comment section below, and we promise that we will read it and write you back and let you know. Thanks for watching.
Thanks for watching. See you soon.
Bye.
Bye.
Hi, I'm Carol.
And I'm Rob. You start again.
Hang on. Why don't you start it?
I can't say, hi, I'm Carol.
Yeah, you can. No. Okay. I can't. I've got the giggles.
Working with amateurs.
Hello.
This is Carol.
No, I'm Carol.
She's Carol. And I'm Rob. And our little
start over. something to tick me off.